So this is going to be a pretty quick one. Sorry if it's not nearly as detailed as the previous videos, but yeah, I mean, there really isn't much to talk about. You know a ton about entity programming at this point, so today's lesson is going to be a breeze. By the way, we've reached the end of chapter 3. The next video should be about weapons, and that is so exciting! So let's start with sprites. They are basically flat little quads that display a sprite texture, and they usually face the camera. You can take a look at the C Sprite class to see roughly how it works. Without it, you would have to load a sprite asset, get its number of frames, and play them manually at a given frame rate, just like we've been doing so far. So if you actually want to create animated sprites and have like a high-level thing to just control them instead of doing it all manually, C Sprite saves you a ton of time. You can basically spawn them through code, set up their parameters and everything, and in fact, here's an example of that. Notice that we're using a SpriteCreate method here. It basically calls getClassPointer for you and initializes some things. It's a neat little utility. So this entity here is basically going to create a couple of sprites and alternate between them when it's triggered. You can kind of think of it as a traffic light, basically. Now, you can use this for all kinds of things, right? You can simulate wind particles in an efficient way, you can have flamethrower particles that can damage a lot of things and stuff like that. Just, one word of caution, I suppose. Don't try to have too many of these. Because if you do, well, I mean, the engine's not going to be able to handle it. Like, if you spawn up to 30 maybe, or 40, yeah, you're fine, but like, don't go over 80 or 100. Just don't do that. Because eventually, like, you're gonna hit the visible entities limit sooner, you're gonna hit edicts, and you're gonna be using a ton of bandwidth, especially if these things are moving. Alright, if you want to do, like, effects with these, the proper way to do it would be to do something on the client side, using the actual particle manager. But more word on that in chapter 7, I think, or 6, I don't know. Anyway, next up. Lasers. You see them all the time in Half-Life. You know, you got these vortigaunts and their funny green beams, you got these laser beams, you got these electric arcs and everything. They're everywhere, basically. Except they're not necessarily laser beams. They're just called beams in the code. So yeah, on the server side, they're all handled in the CBeam class. Essentially, all you gotta do really is to just define two points, start and end, and some other parameters like, I don't know, color, render mode, and stuff like that. And of course the sprite itself. Compared to C-Sprite, it ain't much more complicated. I mean, it's roughly the same, you're just kind of defining two positions and that's basically it. And here's one of the ways you can use it. And just like with sprites, creating beams is actually really simple, because you got this static beam create method here. It really does a lot of work for you. You can specify start and end positions either as points or as actual entities. Because if they're entities, that means your beam can actually follow them. Say you got a moving train or something like that, or you just really want to like connect like two players or something like that, like a beam between, yeah, you can do that, and it's just going to follow them. And it's really neat, like if you want to render a rope, for instance. Yeah, actually, you should probably try implementing the opposing force rope with this. I mean, it's not going to be optimal, like, whatsoever, but hey, I mean, it's a fun exercise. And yeah, there's a bunch of homework I can actually give you with this. And yeah, that's about it. Like, the rest is really just tweaking and doing all these random things with these things, and yeah, that's it. Like, chapter 3 is basically done. Not gonna lie, this was really hastily put together. Sorry about that. I guess we're gonna see each other in March again, cause the next couple of months are gonna be pure chaos. And until then, happy programming.